So start the next lecture for solution of a traveling salesman problem. In the previous lecture we discussed the formulation and what is the meaning of tour, short tour and so on. Now we move to the technique to solve of a transportation of a traveling salesman problem. So here is the technique. It's not the easy technique. Please listen carefully, then you can easily recognize the possibility of solution. Here we take an example of a 5-city problem. It's represent the problem, solve the TSP using branch and bound method. It's very important, branch and bound method. You already know about the term branch, how many number of branches, and bound means they have some restriction to bounds. So here we use to solve a traveling salesman problem using branch and bound method. It's a 5-city problem. It's the example, it's the matrix given for the problem. It's represent if you move from 1 to 2, your costing becomes 10, or your time required 10 hours if the unit is hours. If you move from 1 to 3, then the time required is 8 hours. If you move from 1 to 4, the time required is 9 hours. If you move from 1 to 5, the time required is 7 hours. You can easily observe that its first row is identical with the first column. It represents that the graph is a undirected graph. That means you can move by a particular road, move from a particular city and return along this road. With the same road, this one represent you can move from second city to third city with the costing 10, and second city to fourth city with the costing 5, and second city to fifth city costing is 6. And this represent you can move from third city to first city of costing 8, third city to second city costing 10, third city to fourth city the costing is 8, third city to fifth city costing is 9, fourth city to first city 9, and so on. So in this lecture start with this. Initially you cannot recognize the T structure. So first we move the discuss. Initially just we take the row minimum value and adding all. The first row minimum value is 7, second row minimum value is 5, third row minimum value is 8, occur more than one place, you just choose any one. Fourth row minimum value is 6 and the fifth row minimum value is 6. So the total value is 31. It is known as the lower boundary of the problem. That means the solution of this problem should not exceed, again we repeat, should not exceed, should not be less than 31. That is known as the lower boundary. Exactly for that reason, when we start to create our branching, here we write the lower bound of this problem is 31. Now you can recognize why we consider this first branch and how can I consider this first branch. This one, according to the previous discussion, we have already mentioned that you can move from a particular city to another city. You cannot move from two different cities to a particular city. So if we consider what should be the next city of the first city, if we start from the first city, because when we find the Hamiltonian circuit, it's a circuit, that means you can start from anywhere, either 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5. So initially we start the problem with the first city. I have to recognize, you have to recognize which city should be the next city of which city should be the next city of the city 1. So here we consider x12, that means if you can move from the first city to second city. We have already mentioned that if xij, if you move from ith city to jth city, then we consider 1. If we move from ith city to kth city, then x IKism. So the four different cases arise in the first level of branch or the tree level. First generation of the tree is X12. It's represent you just move from the first city to second city. This represent X13 represents you just move from the first city to third city. This represent you move from the first city to fourth city. This represent you move from the first city to fifth city, because you cannot move from the first city to first city. So the four different way you can move up from the first city to another city. Either you can move 2, or you can move 3, we can move 4, or you can move 5. You just move only one city. So we start our calculation when you move, we will consider you just move from the first city to second city. In this lecture, we just discuss this level. In the next lecture, we discuss the next level. Okay. So the first to second. That was our discussion. Step 2. When you consider x12 equals to 1, in that case, you just delete first row and second column. First row and second column. If you delete the first row and second column, that means you cannot move from the first city to other city. So you have to delete the first row, and you can't move from any other city to second city, so you have to delete the second column. So the remaining matrix becomes, this. Just delete the first row and the second column. Now we consider the least value of every row. In the second row, the least value is 5. In the third row, the least value is 8. In the fourth row, least value is 6. And the fifth row, the least value is 6. So if we consider you just move from the first city to second city, in that case, the total two duration should be 5 plus 8 plus 6 plus 6. Your question should be, why we consider this 10? Because it's represent 2 to 4, the costing is 5, mentioned here. Here we consider 3 to 4, the costing is 8, mentioned here. 4 to 5, the costing is 6, mentioned here. 5 to 4, the costing is 6, mentioned here. So why we consider this 10? That's your question. That should be your question. Why we consider this 10? Because we initially considered you just move from the first city to second city. When you move from the first city to second city, costing becomes 10. So the total costing of these two should be calculated including this 10. That total costing becomes 10 plus 5 plus 8 plus 6 plus 6, that is 35. In the similar manner, if we consider x13, it's very important. If we consider x13, that means you just move from the first city to third city. That means you have to delete the first row and the third column. First row and third column. Just we delete from the table first row and this third column. Okay, so the remaining matrix becomes this. So here we consider the minimum element of every row. Second, this one is 5, this one is 8, or more than one place, you just choose one. Just we calculate the value of the two. So this one should be the minimum value of this particular row, and this one is the minimum value of this particular row. So the total costing, if we move from first city to third city, 5 plus 8 plus 5 plus 6, again we repeat, why we consider this 8? Because here we consider we just move from the first city to third city. The costing for moving from first city to third city is 8. So here we consider 8. So the total duration, total costing, or the total time for these two should be 32. Next one, here we consider x14. Similarly, X on 4, that means represent, that represent you just move from the first city to fourth city. Since you move from the first city to fourth city, so you have to delete the first row from the beginning table, and the fourth column, the remaining table becomes this. And when we calculate the total tour, you should calculate the row minimum from every row. It's 6, it's 8, it's 5, and it's 6, and the 9 is for the costing. You move from the first city to fourth city. This one, first city to fourth city. First city to fourth city, the costing is 9. Next one is this. If we consider X15, that means you just move from the first city. If you consider, you just move from the first city to fifth city. This is 1. So you have to delete the first row and the fifth column. And the way of calculation is you have to select the minimum number from every row. This one is 5, this one is 8, this one is 5, this one is 6, this one is 6. Therefore, the total costing should be 5 plus 8 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. Why consider 7? Again we repeat, just we move from the first city to fifth city, the costing becomes 7. So here we consider 7. So the total costing becomes 31. Okay, here we consider this branch. Now you can recognize why we use the result. 35, we have already calculated X12 is, if we consider X12, the result becomes 35. If we consider X13, the result becomes 32. If we consider the X14, the result becomes 34. If we consider X15, the result becomes 31. That is the first level of bunching. Next, we discuss the second level of bunching. In the next lecture, we discuss the second level of bunching. If you cannot continue listening to the next lecture, then you cannot understand the total problem. So stop for this particular topic up to the first level of branching. So wait for the next lecture. Thank you.